Good afternoon. I'm Tom Rovers, Aluminum Production Manager at IEA, here to talk about our new aluminum brazing furnace. Our product line is very diverse, and the reason that this furnace is so useful in such a product mix that we have is we can load the product on our trays. We can load multiple products on one tray or the max product on another tray, and we can load these on this furnace sequentially, and then from there it indexes and automatically selects the program, the right program for that particular product. And again, that's why this furnace is such a versatile tool, enabling us to build these quality products. First off, in aluminum products that we make, we have to have clad material and non-clad material. The clad material is a thin, think of it as a coating on the material that has higher silicon content that actually melts and makes the braze joint in our products. Flux is what cleans and wets the product. Then as it goes through the furnace, it flows to make the joint. Now, as we mentioned earlier, we go from small products to large products. When we do that, we have to know what temperature to braze this product at. So before any product leaves here, we have the product recipe dialed in. And this is an example. There's several of them here that we did in the last week that we will make our first product, our first prototype. Put this, it's what's called a data pack, on the product, and then in certain areas of the product, and this tells us the temperature as it goes through the furnace. We verify it with this, and we don't release any production until we get a successful data pack through the furnace. Also, before we braze anything, I mentioned cladded, unclad. Every other element of the products that we make have to be clad, unclad. We verify that with this material check gun that we use. And so every product, we verify that, yes, it does have the right aluminum composition to braze. All under one roof. That's the beauty of what we have here at IEA, is to do everything in-house, our vertical integration. So from the design that we have through in engineering, come down to the floor, we have a cross-functional team going over the specifics of the design for manufacturability. Then we get the material ordered, we do our checks, as I mentioned before, assemble the product. After we assemble it, we pick a recipe in our furnace to braze the product. We verify our recipe with our data pack, and then when our product is good, then we'll bring it to the calorimeter and test it in-house, all the thermodynamic properties of that particular product. Because we're vertically integrated, we do everything in-house, and we have ultimate control of making, assembling, brazing, and testing our product. And we do that very expeditiously. We have a great team here across the board, from every hand that touches these components to the testing, to the packaging. We can build the product in any type of order and braze it sequentially. So we could build 10 different products a day, one after another, and get these tested and out the door. As I said, being vertically integrated and our experience in supplying ourselves with what we need, both from an aluminum fab standpoint, purchased aluminum, and assembling the aluminum product, but most importantly, it boils down to the people. People are what make it happen, and we have vast experience in these technologies to hit the ground running. And because of this experience, we're faster to getting a successful product. Our testing, numerous types that I mentioned earlier, and getting it through, packaged, and out the door. And this, again, this furnace being able to change on the fly, literally within 10 minutes, we can braze different products in that fashion. it enables us to satisfy our customer requirements.